All right, so this goes in my top two trailers that I've seen.
That was incredible.
Here.
I feel bad he's not here. Shit.
What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another reaction here. Three Shades of Whatever. Jamie's away for Easter. He'll be back. Stranger Things. Finally got season 4's full trailer.
Nice.
I know we got pieces and I think we got a trailer before, but it wasn't really a trailer. They're all teasers. That's all we always teasers. This is the first like full trailer where you get like something to tell us what's gonna happen. You know, that kind of trailer. All the other bullshit didn't say nothing.
Yeah.
You know? It was still cool to see the Creel House trailer. I don't know if you've seen that, it was before you were with us, but it was basically just like watching a scene from the show, an obscure scene. It's like going into the middle of a book and finding a passage, reading that, and then where's the context? You know what I mean? So we didn't get that. It was cool to see what was going on there. But I'm really dying to see what the hell was going to happen.
Yeah, it's been a while. It's a great show.
Yeah.
I wish I had watched the show more recently. I feel like I haven't watched it forever.
Honestly, I haven't watched the last season is the one I've watched the least. I'm that kind of person, every time a season ends, I like to go back and watch it again.
Yeah.
But for some reason, I didn't do that with the last season. We're going into 4, right?
We're going into 4. Yeah, I believe. Going into 4, because there's 3 seasons. Netflix has a season 1 recap, has a season 2 recap.
Okay.
Does not have a season 3 recap. I'm assuming the season 3 recap is going to come out right before the show comes out.
Mm.
But watching those 2 recaps brought a lot back. I'm like, oh yeah, this, that, and the other. But I want to see the season 3 recap. But I remember, I've seen it.
Season 1 and 2, I know so well. So well. But 3, I remember it well enough. Like, it was the mall one with the Russians working deep under the mall.
Yeah.
And, what's his name?
Doesn't the one girl's brother turn into that monster, or the monster and
Billy?
Yeah,
of course, that's the name I remember.
For some reason, that's the part I remember.
Well, of course, I remember because we have something in common. The end of last season, we end up with, from what I remember, it was at the end of the mall. They were bound down to the mall fighting, right? You have the whole premise was that the Russians were trying to reopen the gate that 11 had closed at the end of season 2.
The Russians wanted the gate open? I can't remember that.
Yes, they were trying to open it to, I don't know, harness the power, whatever their motives could have been. Will's mom, whose name escapes me at the moment, Winona Ryder, and Hopper were fighting with the Russians, trying to destroy the machine that was cutting open the portal.
Ah, yes.
And then he was out there fighting the Russians, right?
Yeah.
Like, hand to fisticuffs, right? And he got locked out there, and it was like the last minute, and she had to hit the switch, and with him still out there, and she hits the switch, and poof, the machine blows, and you see people like turn to dust.
Yeah.
And we're under the impression that Hopper was wiped out there as well.
The impression.
But then we saw the trailer where at the end of last season, they showed him in a cell, and I think we just assumed it was a Russian cell, but then that you see him in Russia, in a Russian camp or some sort.
Yeah. Which I heard is not a good place to be.
No.
One of the worst places to be in the world.
You might end up getting tough.
Real tough.
Yeah.
You'd be getting stretched, too.
I mean, that's where you had to go?
I like season 1 and 2 a lot better. But season 3 was like, it took things to a level where I thought it was like going a little too far and bringing Russians in and the huge monster. I think just a huge monster storyline would have been totally fine. Seeing that giant five-legged thing.
Yeah.
Doing something with that would have been totally fine with me.
Okay.
Like, adding all the Russian stuff in it, I thought it was just became like, eh.
That's right. They were fighting that big-ass monster in the food court.
Yeah.
And when the gate collapsed, the gate closed, it collapsed.
Yeah.
I think that's all that happened with it, right?
Yeah, something like that. I think the subtlety of the first 2 seasons of what made the show so great. Like,
dude,
not knowing exactly
season
what's going
1
on,
the way that started,
it was so
instantly
good. That's
the best brought
one.
Me back to my childhood, bro.
Yeah.
I mean, I know you don't remember the 80s that way, but damn do I, bro. And it was just, it was like, you know what it reminded me of? It was like watching a show that I missed from the 80s now.
Yeah.
Because it was so authentic.
It does have an authentic feel.
You know, the soundtrack, the look, the way they act and talk, everything was just really, really well done. Even the kids pulled it off so perfectly. And it was cool to see.
It's cool to see them get older with each season and their characters progress.
Yeah. I call it the Harry Potter effect. Because that's, you know, like when you first watched Harry Potter in 2001, they're little things, like 10-year-olds.
Yeah.
You know, by the last one, they're freaking adults. It's crazy. Yeah. You get to see the progression of them growing up as we do with these kids.
Mm-hmm.
But I think we've jabbered on enough. Let's see what's going on.
Let's see.
You've broken everything. Your suffering is almost at an end.
Yeah, that's right. Billy bit it.
Dear Billy, I don't know if you can even hear this. Ever since you left, everything's been a total disaster. For a while, we tried to be happy.
Wow.
Normal. I know that's impossible.
Located you guys far from Hawkins because I thought you'd be safe. A war is coming. I'm afraid your friends at Hawkins are very much in the eye of the storm.
I don't have my powers.
I don't know how to say this other than just to say it. Without you, we can't win this war.
See you on the other side.
On the other side.
I was convinced I was put here for some other reason. Maybe I can still help. Even if it's the last thing I do.
People say Hawkins is cursed. They're not way off.
Masters of the Universe 1986 Skeletor was that thing. I'm taking my ass a lap.
Yeah,
what was happening?
That is lap worthy.
Holy shit.
Hold on, it's coming out in two volumes.
Two.
Did you see that?
I didn't.
At the end?
Does that just mean a mid-season finale? Or are they going to make it, like, literally separate into two parts?
This and the Star Wars trailer.
Yeah, Obi-Wan.
The Obi-Wan trailer. Are the two best trailers I have seen.
These are up there for us, man. I mean, for me at least, because We've been doing this for quite a while now, man. A little over a year now, and
that was mind-blowing.
Dude.
If the show is half as good as that trailer, which it will be, because the show's good.
I'm going to say this about trailers nowadays. Whoever is making these needs a raise.
Yeah.
Because it doesn't matter what the hell it is. For the most part, they make it intriguing. And they make things that I want to see way more, like, oh, Jesus.
That looked like it literally closes the storyline on so many questions. And I hope it does.
It's not going to. You know how I know that? Because they renewed for season 5.
Oh, I thought they said every story has an end.
I thought so too. I thought this was supposed
to be the trailer just then?
I thought this was supposed to be the final. Hawkins is a hotbed of paranormal activity. They can do anything they want there, basically. I mean, as far as storyline.
Yeah.
You know? How many times could you open and close this freaking portal? Just because one jackass decides to close it or reopen it doesn't mean the other one can't start the same thing again, you know?
Is that mummified dude or whatever the hell he is? What? That zombie guy?
In the Resident Evil was that.
Is he like the god or the president of the Upside Down?
Possibly. I don't know, but that thing was... That thing... That's the first thing from that side that thinks, that thing talks.
Right, that actually, yes, that, you know, has like a conscience.
Yes, we haven't heard anything with cognitive ability that we know of, speaking-wise, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, you could tell the other ones are maybe smart. Not really, no. Because even the Demogorgon was just sniffing out people, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And then the Demodogs, no different. This thing has smarts.
Yeah.
So.
Is he like the Odin of the Upside Down?
I'm telling you, he looked like they were growing Skeletor.
Yeah. Dude, all the tentacles that were coming out of him, he was floating down. Dude, they have to make whatever leader of this Upside Down has to be super creepy. Has to be scary as hell. And he looked
super creepy and scary as hell. You seen all the tentacles? Are like the Demodogs, Demogorgons, whatever, extensions of him? Do you understand? You know what I'm saying?
Does his life force?
Is he connected? Like, is he like, for lack of a better term, the Borg? You know what the Borg is?
No.
From Star Trek, she was the collective. Oh. There was a whole army, but controlled by her brain.
Well, he definitely has. Well, he has to have control of them.
Do you know what I'm saying?
Like, I don't think they're listening to him.
But not control like a dictator control. I'm talking about like controlling. Yeah.
I think that's.
Like telekinesis kind of shit, maybe.
Yeah.
Let's go again.
You've broken everything.
Yes. Good call. I didn't catch that. Yeah, good call.
Your suffering.
And here's the clock.
Is it counting? Or what clock is it?
Wait a minute. Yeah, that's what he was saying. Okay. That clock was in the Creel House trailer. Okay? And then we saw that same clock in the wall of the school when the redhead was looking at it. Sam.
Yeah.
Counting
down. Dear Billy, I don't know if you can even hear this. Ever since you left, everything's been a total disaster.
And could you get more 80s than putting this song in there?
Dude, this song is great,
isn't it?
I forgot to say something about that. This song hypes so, it up.
Doesn't it? The way they play it, too.
And then they threw the guitar solo at the end.
It's impossible.
Right, here's the clock.
Yeah. Come on, Steve Perry's voice.
Sang. You guys far
you
from Hawkins.
Sang.
Kids look older
because
too.
I thought you'd be safe.
Obviously, you know, it's just crazy how kind you are.
Oh, she got a Russian package. You see that? There's a Russian stamp.
Yeah.
I'm afraid your friends and Hawkins are very much.
That's the Creel House.
In the eye of the storm.
Oh, okay. And it like went back in time and showed the family that lived in it.
She said she doesn't have her powers.
I did hear that. Maybe it's just not working for her.
Without you.
Maybe it's like
we can't win this war.
A Spider-Man 2 thing. Where it's just in his head.
See you on the other side.
On the other side.
He's convinced I was put here for some other reason. Maybe I can still help.
They got him doing gladiator games?
Even if it's the last thing I do.
What the hell is that? Demodog or some sort?
I think they have control over something.
People say Hawkins is a curse. way off.
Oh. You have long hair because of the dirt. You can't get caught.
Yeah. It's time.
So they go into the upside down and fight the door.
Yeah. And what the hell are they?
You have lost.
Dude looks so cool. Volume 1, May 27th. Volume 2,
July 1st.
So there's only two Oh, it's a two episode thing.
No, horseshit. No.
It has to be, dude.
Horseshit. Nope. Nope.
Oh, no, wait. Maybe half a season.
That's what I'm saying.
Half a season.
Exactly right.
Volume.
I think it's either going to be 4 or 8 episodes twice. We might get 16. Yeah. We might only, it might be 5 and 5, but I do think it's going to be.
I don't think it's 16.
I don't think it's 16. I think it's either going to be 4 and 4 or 5 and 5, 4 and 6.
I see a 4 and 4.
6 and 6, maybe even.
6 is 12. They've only done 8 in a season.
Maybe.
Every season was 8.
I know, but maybe that's why they're doing 2 volumes.
Maybe. Maybe this is bigger. Maybe it's got a lot of storylines.
Because all this shit went down during COVID, man. So maybe they, to make up for that, they just said, screw it, let's keep filming.
I wonder if they were in a bubble when they were filming this.
Oh, shit.
Were they in a COVID bubble?
Crack the door open, drop the plate, push, shut the door.
Did they, like, when they were going to eat food, like, they sat down and took their mask off and started eating, and then when they stood up, they put their mask back on? Because when you sit down and eat, there's no COVID.
You got your protective barrier around you. Come on.
But when you stand up, COVID.
Dude, you know that they got the switch up in the front? They hit it, boom, you get the bubble around your table. You're fine.
Yeah. It all makes sense. It's perfect. It's science, bro.
After a quick Google search. And the sucking of a Tic Tac. That's right. Pause. 9 episodes. Most likely 5 and 4. I think it's going to be 5 then 4 episodes.
Yeah.
I don't see them doing 4 then 5. Doesn't make sense. 5 and 4. You know?
Yeah, we'll go with 1's going to be 5. 1's going to be 4. Like 1 and 8 don't make sense, right? 2 and 6. Probably not. 6 and 3. What if they give us 8? And make us wait for the last one. You know what, though? It'll build up that last one. It'll be a lot of anticipation.
But the point of that is, why don't we just go back to like having Netflix be like Disney with theirs and Star Wars and shit? Because I personally love the anticipation of waiting that week.
So do I. There's something is lost in these shows. Yeah. And you could watch them all at once.
I won't do it. I mean,
I do it. When one episode is over, I just click skip, go, next, bam, done.
Yeah.
And I'm watching it.
I can't do it. Like, I mean,
I usually stop watching when I fall asleep.
I don't want it to all be over in a day.
Out of food.
It looks fantastic. I can't friggin' wait. We've got, it's like right around the corner. We got a little over a month left till we get to it. So,
and then we get Obi-Wan too. All right, cool.
Yeah.
You seem very okay to me. My diagnosis?